Congressman, thank you so much for joining us. CNN has just learned, you know this, that this conservative lawyer, John Eastman, says he will defy the subpoena from your committee. How will your committee respond to this defiance?
Well, I guess what he is saying, and I think he made this public in a interview he did with Steve Bannon, of all people, is that he intends to assert the Fifth. And we will try to ascertain when he does, as we will when we have the opportunity to depose Mr. Clark, who has also said he intends to assert the Fifth, whether they are asserting it in good faith because they believe they may be implicated in criminal activity, or whether they're merely trying to cover up for the former president. And it's a difficult determination to make. If he genuinely believes that his testimony would implicate him in crime, then he does have a right to assert the Fifth. But we'll do our best to determine whether that's being done properly. And there, of course, may be a great many questions that he can answer without fear of incrimination.
Eastman says the partisan makeup of your select committee, the way it was organized, he says makes it invalid. Therefore, he does not need to cooperate. What do you say to that?
Well, that's a frivolous argument. If he uses that as a basis to refuse to answer questions, then he'll be in contempt of the committee, and it will be fairly simple and straightforward. So we'll be seeing with each witness, you know, with Meadows, with Clark, with Eastman and others, whether they're properly invoking a privilege, whether they are merely trying to stall and delay or cover up for the former president. And we will make our judgment as to what the repercussions should be once we see and hear their testimony.
CNN has now obtained a copy of former White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows' forthcoming book, supposed to be released next week, where he actually doubles down on the baseless claim that the 2020 presidential election was stolen and whitewashes the violent attack on January 6th. In the book, he writes this, and let me read this quote. He says, Trump did not call for violence. He did not expect anyone would enter the Capitol building. Could these new disclosures actually, though, undermine Meadows' executive privilege claims?
Oh, absolutely. Up till now, he's been saying that I can't answer relevant questions before the committee because the former president is asserting executive privilege. But apparently, he felt more than comfortable writing about these things, which, you know, presumably you have to expect that Meadows would have cleared that with the former president. And if the former president waived his privilege so that Meadows could write about it, he cannot then assert privilege to prevent him from answering questions about it. So I think there's a very powerful case if indeed, as CNN is reporting, that he writes about conversations he had with the president, that any privilege would be waived. But frankly, even if it isn't waived, the holder of the privilege is the current president, and Joe Biden is saying he is not asserting any privilege here. The public has a need to know.
Your committee also just announced, Congressman, that the deposition with former Trump Justice Department official Jeffrey Clark, originally scheduled for tomorrow, has now been postponed until December 16th. What more can you tell us about this postponement, and do you still expect he will plead the Fifth when he does appear?
Well, I can only say that the committee is confident that this request based on a medical condition is a valid one. So it does not appear to be some kind of a ruse. So we, you know, certainly hope that his health improves. In terms of what he will do when he does appear, and I'm confident he will appear. It may be that he asserts a Fifth because he believes that his testimony may implicate him in crime. Now, that's an extraordinary thing for someone who is at the senior most levels of the Justice Department, that they feel the need to plead the Fifth, that they might have been involved in criminal activity. But he has made a whole series of other very spurious claims when he appeared before as a basis for refusing to answer. And mind you, Wolf, when he did appear before, he made no suggestion that he thought that his answers might incriminate him. So again, we will try to determine whether he's operating in good faith, bad faith, or some mixture of the above before we decide on what steps may be appropriate.
Can you share what kind of health issue he's citing?
You know, the short answer is I don't know. And if I did, I probably wouldn't be in a position to share that either out of respect for his health condition, but I am told by the committee staff that he provided ample documentation of that so that we knew that it was not a ruse.
Congressman Adam Schiff, thank you so much for joining us. Good luck.